This is a story about Charlie. Charlie is a 71-year-old war veteran who suffers from diabetes. In spite of that, Charlie likes to remain active, and every day he enjoys taking a walk through the park with his dog, Snappy. A few weeks ago, Charlie got a pebble in his shoe as he was walking through the park. He didn't notice it due to the loss of sensation in his foot and continued on. Once home, Charlie was surprised and frustrated to find a small wound on his foot. The last time this happened, more than a year ago, his doctor had used negative pressure to treat the wound. Charlie decided to do some research of his own so that he understood more about negative pressure therapy. While searching online for negative pressure wound therapy, Charlie came across a website of a new, innovative device called the SNaP Wound Care System. He was impressed by what he read and wanted to talk it over with his doctor. Charlie's doctor, Dr. Green, has been using the SNAP system for the past 6 months, and after evaluating Charlie's diabetic foot ulcer, decided that this was an appropriate wound for the SNAP device. Dr. Green found the system to be easy to use and thought that there were many benefits for the patient as well. Because it was small and silent, her patients could wear it without anyone knowing they had a wound. In addition, it required no electricity or batteries to operate. Here's how Dr. Green applied the SNAP system. Before beginning, prepare the wound bed and peri-wound skin per institutional protocol. If necessary, apply a skin protectant to the skin surrounding the wound. Cut the saline moistened gauze or the blue foam to fit the wound. Do not pack any dressings into the wound. If using blue foam, cut the foam piece to fit the size and shape of the wound. To begin application of the SNAP wound care system, slowly peel away the center release liner as you carefully place the SNAP dressing over the wound. Ensure the center opening of the port is placed directly over the interface dressing. Use your hands to smooth out the hydrocolloid dressing onto the skin and remove any small creases. Next, remove the side release liners one at a time as you carefully press the rest of the hydrocolloid dressing to the skin. Again, use your hands to smooth out the dressing to ensure an airtight bond to the skin. It's often helpful to hold your warm hands over the dressing to ensure the adhesive properly adheres to the skin. Next, place the SNAP strap. For most lower extremity wounds, it's best to place the strap just below the knee. Take care to ensure the strap is not placed too tightly, as this may cause discomfort or decreased blood flow to the extremity. Cut the tubing to the desired length so the tubing reaches the bottom of the cartridge without too much slack. Fully insert the tube fitting into the tubing. Connect the SNAP cartridge to the tube fitting. To activate the cartridge, remove the activation key by pressing the tabs on the sides of the key and pulling. The green visual indicator should remain stationary to verify that there are no leaks. Place the SNAP cartridge into the strap. With the small, silent, and discreet therapy in place, Charlie was able to resume his daily walks with Snappy. In fact, he was able to do everything he normally would, even while his diabetic foot ulcer healed. The SNAP Wound Care System. Active healing that's out of sight.